I was doing yoga for many years, okay, but I didn't know all these things. No knowledge, it was just an attraction to do yoga, master the mind. So the mastery was the mind and yoga, body and all was a childhood, like people are interested in cricket, I am interested in that only. Sitting for meditation, trying to meditation. I don't know what to meditate. At least somebody said, look at the third eye, do something. So I kept on doing that.
Without a master?
No, I had a guru. Of course, yoga guru was there. But he is able to teach standard yoga practices. Good amount. Of course, some asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Whatever extent he knows, he taught. So whatever extent I could understand, I was following. Then I went to IIT. Then I came and worked with C. Shravana Kumar, my colleague there. So the work was very intense, and I put my full effort into that, actually 100%. So probably that work became my karma yoga also, from hatha yoga to karma yoga also. Never a point of time I thought, what is the benefit of that? What is the money involved? What is this? I was fully karma yogi. Not that I knew karma yoga, okay. Not that I knew it. It was a karma yoga happened. So then one day, I used to do sandhyavana once or twice, two times a day whenever I get time. Evening I used to do. So sandhyavana, while doing sandhyavana, suddenly a lot of energy started rushing into my head. Here, fill my nervous system. So then I opened my eyes. Then I started, I looked at everything. Everything is I. Oneness. The wall, the trees, the mountain, everything is one whole. So that I call it God or whatever. I didn't know anything. But the experience was so mind-boggling, mind-shattering. It changed my whole life. And I cried profusely. And there were goosebumps on my body. Wonderful experience. Then also what happened is I lost sense of I and the other. Whenever I talk to somebody, I always feel that I am there, oneness is there. The ego had not gone, ego was there, a subtle ego was there, the ego had taken a bigger shape. I am part of the bigger. So I would say that, probably that was Vishishta Advaita. I am there as an individual, but I am a part of the larger whole. And everybody is connected, that became very clear to me. Like a bird is flying, I felt I am also flying. Yes, I means that the flying is like an experience. So like that, it continued. And it's not a one-time affair, it's day to day, every day.
Every day?
It continued for many years like that.
It's you not, were working?
I was working. So everything was, I understood that nobody can understand this, nobody can explain this. So I didn't talk to anybody else, so I kept on doing, working. But life had, internally entire thing had changed. My worldview had changed. Worldview was earlier, I was individual, struggling in life. The competition at IIT was intense, the competition in my school was intense. I was struggling, working hard. So all those things, a deeper sense of oneness. Anything comes in life, very wonderful, it's a divine grace. The feeling of God became more and more. When I hear God's name, I used to cry. When I hear to anything, I used to feel bhakti started increasing. So from, I would say this, logically, from Hatha Yoga to Karma Yoga to Bhakti Yoga, it started. Okay, then I used to chant Hare Krishna. As I chant, tears will be coming. So I chant God's name. I used to spend time chanting. Okay, so office work was also intense from morning to night, 8:30. Then I'll eat food and start sit for meditation, 9 o'clock to 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the night. Okay, when I go into office, later part I used to go and hire a driver. So I used to time to spend on going through scriptures. So what happened, suddenly some of the scriptures started attracting me. That till that time I didn't have any exposure to scripture. Only scripture I knew was Bible.
Bible.
Because I was taught Bible in my school days. I was learned in a missionary school. Bhagavad Gita and all. But everything started attracting me. And one thing I found is that all these scriptures immediately make sense to me. That's like the deeper essence immediately opens up. Nobody has to teach me that this thing. Whatever the words are there, I get the inner sense. And if the speaker is telling the truth, I used to cry. Otherwise, if it doesn't not speak the truth, I used to get up and go. Because I could sense the essence. So I went through intense learning on Advaita Vedanta. Some teaching of Advaita Vedanta. Intense means whenever I get opportunity. Advaita Vedanta from Arshavidya Kendra. So Advaita Vedanta from Bandhanji Govindacharya. So I get attracted. Not that I want to learn anything. Somehow I sit and listen, I feel so joyful, peaceful. Rather cry. So that's how it went on. And the mind became settled but very powerful. The bhakti, mind becomes very powerful. Okay, that's why Rama says to Hanuman, okay, you are very fortunate. For you, I am there. For me, nobody is there. Okay, what happens is that as a bhakta, you place so much of trust on God. Things will happen like magic. Miracles happen in bhakta's life. Miracles. Many miracles happen. Because for you, God is real and you are real. The miracle is real. So like that, I saw many miracles. Think of something, something will happen. So those things happen. Then I went through intense, I left CDOT and I started my own company. So there, after some time, there was a technology downturn in 2001. The Broadcom bust, they call. So I lost a lot of money, a lot of trouble, a lot of losses, no savings, no job, a lot of intense difficulties. But not a single day I didn't have any suffering, neither my wife. So all of we are facing life as if nothing has happened, peaceful. It's not a mental positive thinking. It's that, yeah, this is God's gift. God is taking care. Probably that is, I think, some of the karmic impressions related to negative karmic impressions going out. What it is intense, very tough. I have seen a lot of tough things in life. And it is a day-to-day which is very... this thing. I mean, it was to the extent that many times I didn't know whether I would come back alive that much. Because some of the creditors, some of the gundas, so many, it's a tough life. Some false cases, so many things I got, it happened. So I went through everything as a God's gift. Anything comes, it's just a gift. So, and God, the oneness concept was always overpowering. So like that it went on. Then... okay, there are many miracles happening. Each of them is a miracle. What happens is the mind becomes expanded. In that expansion, everything is connected in the universe. So you think of something like wire, it gets happens. So it happens. So even these troubles, a lot of troubles come. Within no time, it gets resolved. It gets resolved. Right. So that was the point. Then I studied some many of the scriptures, not very formally, listen to something and I study, just to understand what I am going through, because there was no guide to me, tell me what exactly is. I listen to something, then I contemplate. While traveling to the office, I use a driver will be there, I'll sit and contemplate. So like that, just I was trying to relate my experience with what is there in scriptures, trying to correlate. So then, back in around 2004 or 2005, I wanted, this continued for almost, this is started in 1989 and went up to 2004, what I call as, I would call it as a Vishishtadvaita experience, but I don't know whether that is the oneness. So then, I felt a urge to meet Ajja, the person, Ajja. Right. I urged to meet Ajja. Didn't know where he was, who is there. That time internet and I was not there.
But how did you hear of Ajja? I met him in Bangalore then went to Puttur.
I read a small news item that about Ajja. A small news item on any of the some people. I thought I meet Ajja, I have to meet. So then it was August 14th, Independence Day. August 15th is Independence Day. I had holiday for the this thing. We travelled on 14th. We heard that he's in Puttur, we don't know where he was. Then we asked many people, Ajja. Some of them laughed, there's no Ajja, old man, sure, this is Ajja, they mocked it. Then somebody told Ajja is here. Then we went to a place called Gandhi Ashram. Then by the time we reached there, it was 10 o'clock in the night. Then Ashram had said, tomorrow morning you can meet Ajja. And they gave us food and all. We slept there. Next day morning, we got up. It's Independence Day. There's a flag hoisting ceremony. Many people believed that Ajja is the incarnation of Gandhi.
They said so.
Because he used to call many of his colleagues and associates by the names of the Gandhiji's. This thing. So he was laying in Gandhi Ashram also. Then the flag hoisting ceremony is there. Now flag hoisting there, and the organizer is in a dilemma. What has happened? They have printed 500 invitation cards. Typically every year they will call villagers to come there. So this year the 500 invitation cards, I just said don't send to anybody. Why? I have invited people, they will come. So now these people are waiting, nobody is coming. Only four of us are there. Myself, my wife, my two children, and my office colleague, and his driver, his wife. 6-7 people are there, and these people, nobody is coming. Ajja doesn't answer anything. So they're waiting. Then they said, we'll do the flag hoisting. Time is getting over. Villages are not there. Every time, their villages will be coming. So flag hoisting is over. Then typically, after Independence Day, Ajja will come and sit in his chair here. And people will sit in front. So the villagers will come and listen to some words from Ajja. This time also they put a plastic chair. People are sitting and doing some people start gathering and they start chanting bhajan. Ajja said he's not there. Somebody went and inside Ajja asked Ajja, Swatantra, so Independence Day, can you come and say? Just, I am experiencing my Swatantra, I am free. I don't want to come and give any speech. Swatantra and both are named Parlanda. So he doesn't come. We don't know his behavior. Because nobody did, right? So we came all the way from Bangalore, Samma. So this guy is not coming out. Okay, I thought at least have a darshan, look at him. He's not coming out. Then I asked this organizer, can you ask whether we can come and meet him? This protocol we don't know. So we went there. He said to come. And then myself, my wife, my two children, and my colleague, and his wife, and driver. We had come in two cars. So then Ajja started shouting, some blabbering. Blah, 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 blah. Nobody can understand what he is speaking of. My colleague started looking at my face. I told him he is a great saint and all. This guy doesn't understand me. Then he and my driver and his wife got fed up with his blabbering. They went away. Even Ajja is talking very correct. I invited you only two people, you and your wife. Why did you bring these people? See, they have gone out. They are not invited. Oh. Invitation not for them. So, we were the two guests who invited for the Independence Day since. Who knows? So then, okay, then, why Prabhu Gada New York Mandira? Why you have come there? Then, at that time, I had a vague concept called Mukti. Vague. Vague concept of liberation. Vague. I didn't know what is Mukti and all. I was enjoying bliss of God and so blissful. It's very wonderful state of expanded consciousness. Okay. I thought there's something more than this. I didn't know what is the more. So I said, Mukti must be something more than this. I said, Mukti beko. Ajja laughed. Mukti beko? Okay. Who is there sitting here actually? My wife. Take her permission and I'll give Mukti now itself. So he was teasing her. My wife got worried. She also doesn't know what is Mukti. She thought we have come with two children, our young children, right? So Mukti means this fellow sits here, what to do? No. Mukti. Then Ajja was teasing her. So then I told, okay, you don't want Mukti for me. At least you ask Mukti for yourself. That's okay, that's also okay for me. She said, no Mukti for us, nothing. Go, let's go. So then Ajja gave me instruction on self-inquiry. Find out who you are. Okay. Then he gave me two inquiries. Find out who you are. Okay, told me the first thing. Then, after finding out who you are, don't move. Summanero. For Summanero, he had given only one instruction. If mosquito comes and sits on your face, don't move your hand like this. So like that, Summanero. Then we went back. So I went back and I used to do anyway meditation in the night. So I used to, now earlier the meditation was everything is Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma, practically. All is Brahma. Now the question came, who am I? Earlier was the self-relation called Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma, all is Brahma. Now who am I? Suddenly everything collapsed. the world is not here, not there yet. The Brahman given nothing is just so we become like now earlier all there was oneness. So from that oneness I started, ended up with nothingness. Okay, so this is actually complementary of that. Fullness is complementary. But oneness, in that oneness there was an ego. In this nothingness there is a emptiness. So that's how. Then somewhere I felt the urge to teach. So my neighbor used to come and sit. Neighbor was a Osho Bhakta. He had studied a lot about Osho. He used to ask many questions, and every question I used to give answers which was appropriate. He was surprised. He used to tell me that you are giving such a clear answer. I want to catch your mech. Somewhere I want you to miss. So you have very good knowledge. He passed away. Some students started coming, started teaching them. So it doesn't mean that you have to have this experience. Somehow it was a waking up call for me because of whatever sadhana I had done earlier.
Thank you for sharing.
I appreciate it. Start, I close.